We're down here under the auspices of one woman. Her name is Kelly O'Neill, and Kelly... And there she is now. But, Kelly's my fast friend down here and a great supporter. And she's the reason we have any gigs at all down here and introduced us to Folk Alley and all of it. So a wonderful woman. And she's responsible for this song, so you can blame her if you don't like it. But she knows me really well, and we always stay at her place on the edge of Lake Erie. And you all know how bucolic and beautiful Northern Ohio is. It is extremely bucolic and beautiful, and all the, you know, the orchards and the vineyards and all the rest of it. And personally, I kind of like a really good industrial landscape myself, and very, very fond of that. And Kelly knows that quite well. And there we were staying at her mom and dad's cottage on the edge of Lake Erie, and she says to me one day, David, you really need to see this place I've found. And I said, oh, is that right, Kelly? And she said, yeah, she get your day off. I said, yeah, I've got the day off. And she said, it's an industrial landscape. I said, what are we waiting for? Let's go, you know, like, why waste a perfectly sunny day in a green field, you know, and let's go. So she took me down the lake, and she took me to Ashtabula, Ohio. Hey, hey, I love it. Hey, anyway, well, may you laugh. I loved it. Here we go. All three of us like Ashtabula. Anyway, I thought it was fantastic, you know, and we got down into the harbor area, and, you know, the cobblestones, the streets turned to cobblestones down there. That's pretty great. There's a ship's chandler's shop on your left-hand side. There's that lovely tilting bridge that separates the inner harbor from the outer harbor, and the inner harbor has the sailboats and everything, and the outer harbor has the big boats that I like to carry, the coal, you know. And you look across the harbor, I started thinking, I really like this place already, but I looked across the harbor, and I saw that giant rail yard over there, and it's full of those gray hopper cars, and the hopper cars themselves, and turned. Are filled with coal. And I thought to myself, man, I like this already, you know. And I just was wondering, I wonder where those coal cars come from, you know. And just at that moment, Kelly looks up at me and says, David, see those coal cars? They come all the way from the coal fields of Kentucky. And I just went, how romantic can you get? You know? I thought it was the most romantic thing I'd ever heard in my life up to that point, you know. And I just thought, wow. So I started writing the song right away, you know, and which is how I write songs in my head, you know. And so it was all going swimmingly well, and I managed to finish it because we went to the Marine Museum in Ashtabula, and I bet you haven't been there yet. You should go. It won't take you long to go through. It's just a small museum, you know. But it's, you'll see the history of Ashtabula in behind these, wooden glass cases. It's all in there in black and white pictures, you know, like Kurt Vonnegut said, soot and chalk, you know, just beautiful, beautiful black and white pictures of the past. And you saw the heyday of Ashtabula. Now it's a coal port on the edge of Lake Erie, but I sure love it. And I wrote this song about it called Ashtabula.